Hey guys, I've got in my hands right here the newest, latest pocket lifesaver or combat lifesaver kit from us at Student of the Gun. I won't belabor you guys with the history of the pocket lifesaver. I've talked about it many times. But what is in our kit? What are in most of our kits? Well, this kit in particular, all right, the combat lifesaver kit, it's the largest, most inclusive kit we have. So we start out, we've got a R.A.T.S. tourniquet, the olive drab, the new R.A.T.S. olive drab, and this is a 2.0 version. All right, that's the R.A.T.S. tourniquet. I've got an NPA nasopharyngeal airway. I've got a 14-gauge stainless steel chest decomp needle. An adhesive bandage for those things that don't require tourniquets, but you still should cover the wound anyway. A couple of alcohol wipes to clean the wound, to put the bandage on, okay. A mini gauze. You can use the mini gauze to wrap or to pack. All right. Got the tan colored duct tape here. That's what we put in our kits, is the tan colored duct tape. 3 feet of it. We've got a Mylar space blanket to keep your patient from going into shock and keep them warm after you've treated them. Okay. And we are also including a 4-inch North American Rescue pre-made pressure dressing in these kits. And of course, these are non-latex gloves. These are actually good gloves, and they're extra large because why? Because small people can put their hands in extra large gloves, but people with extra large hands cannot put their hands in small gloves, right? There's one other item that I didn't mention yet that we've been putting in our kits for years and years and years, and kind of tongue-in-cheek, I've been calling them the 18 Delta Combat Blood Soaker. And the reason I called them an 18 Delta Combat Blood Soaker, for those of you that don't know, the military U.S. Army designation for a Special Forces medic is 18 Delta. And when I was taught about 10 years, no, more than 10 years ago, 10, 12 years ago, when I was taught TCCC, I was taught by U.S. Army combat veteran, 18 Deltas, and also Air Force pararescue guys. And one of the things that the 18 Deltas always had in their kit, in addition to the normal issued stuff, was they had these right here. These maxi pads and tampons. All the stuff, out of all the stuff in this kit, I've got a 4-inch, 3.5-inch, what have you, stainless steel, 14-gauge decomp needle, right? I've got a nose hose to go inside of your nose, all the way back to the back of your throat to maintain an open airway. I've got tourniquets, right? I've got duct tape, all that stuff. Out of everything in the kit, what sends people over the moon? This little guy here, this 25-cent tampon. People write paragraphs about how terrible it is and how awful it is and how dangerous it is. Did I ever say one time to use tampons to stuff bullet wounds? No, never. Not one time ever did that. We threw it in there as kind of a tongue-in-cheek thing. Stick it up your nose. You got a nosebleed, shove it up your nose. All right. We have shown in our survival kits how you can take this and you can fluff it up and it becomes a giant cotton ball and it catches sparks to use as tinder for an emergency fire. If your closet stinks, soak this in essential oils, soak it in peppermint oil, and hang it up in your closet. Your closet won't stink anymore. If you want to paint your toes and you can't get your little pinky toe separated from your other toe, take this and shove it between your toes so when you paint your toes that they won't get the paint on the other one. All right? If you have a woman in your life that has that, oops, this just happened situation, and I don't have anything on me, most of them do, but just say they don't, hand this to her and say, happy birthday. Go crazy. What drives me, I guess, the almost drives me to drink is this. Of all the things in this kit, and of all the things that are going on in the world today, in the United States of America today, we have local, state, and federal government agencies that are completely ignoring and circumventing the law of the land, the Bill of Rights, and the Constitution. We have government agencies that are circumventing and ignoring the First Amendment, the Second Amendment, the Fourth Amendment, the 15th Amendment, the 14th Amendment. And what are we arguing about? We're writing paragraphs and we're having lengthy conversations on Facebook and what have you about the pros and cons of a tampon. Ladies and gentlemen, here's what I'm going to tell you. In this world today, the world that we live in, there are a lot more things that should require your attention than whether or not a 25-cent tampon is inside of a medical kit. You want to fix this world? You want to do something valuable with your time and energy? Address the real problems and quit worrying about the tampon. That's it, bitches.